Many unexperienced Flutter developers choose very long names for variables, methods, classes, and so on. However, readability studies show that longer text and long text lines are more difficult to read compared to shorter text and shorter text lines. Therefore, instead of choosing long identifier names, you should always try to be as precise and short as you can so that it is easier to read. So let's assume this variable name here is different, such as greeting text message. So this variable name consists of three different words, greeting, text, and message. And to find a great short variable name, you should always ask if each of these words is really critical to the meaning of this variable. So let's start with the first word. The first word says that this variable holds a greeting. And with this, we have important information about the value here on the right side. So this is a greetings message. Let's also look at the second word, which is text. And now you should ask yourself, is this word really critical to the meaning of this variable? And it is not really critical because that this variable is a text, you already see on the value on the right side. So this is a string, so you know it is already a text. And also here on the left side, you see the type is a string, so you know it is a text. And therefore, it is not so common and not useful to keep this text inside of the variable name. Therefore, I have removed this text, and now let's go to the last word, message. Is this a critical word to understand the meaning of this value here on the right side? I think it could be fine to keep this greeting message as a variable name if you really want to be precise about the value on the right side. However, this message word is similar to the text word, and we have noticed that here this is a string, so we already know that it is a text, and here also on the right side by the value we know it is a text, and therefore you could also argue that this message is maybe not needed. And now the great thing is that you still understand the meaning of this variable because you know it is a greeting and you know it is a text, so you know it is a greeting text that we store inside of this variable. Next, let's look at this local variable name. And as you can see, this local variable name is really, really long and makes our code really complicated to read. Let's replace the variable name by another name, split greeting list. And here on the right side, you see we are using the greeting variable and we split it. And the result is then of list type. And now you might think, okay, this is a really great name for your variable. However, like you can see, this is still a really long name. It is not really precise about what the meaning of this variable is. And therefore, we need to find a better name. So let's look at all the words inside of this variable name. First of all, we start with the list word. Is this really critical to the meaning of this variable? No, it is not really critical because on the left side, you already have the variable type and this is of type list. So we already know it is a list and therefore this doesn't give us any more information. And therefore you should always make sure that you remove these unnecessary words. Next, let's look at the remaining variable name, split greeting. So here we cannot call it greeting because we have already used it. And you might think, okay, this is a really great name because, yeah, we are splitting basically the greeting message by this character. In general, yes, this would be fine to call it like split greeting. However, you could also be more precise about what is the meaning behind this method. What is this really doing? And what this method is doing, it is taking all these spaces inside of this greeting message and splits our whole string by these spaces so that we have in the end result a list of multiple words, hello and flutter. Therefore, I tend to rename this variable name to the meaning of this code on the right side. So what is this basically doing? It is splitting our greeting message into multiple words. And therefore, I want to call this variable name simply words. So right now, our words variable holds a list. And inside of this list, we have two strings, hello and flutter. Next, let's look at this code. Here you see we have a very long variable name. And therefore, we should make this definitely shorter. So let's give it, for example, the name string text. Now you should ask yourself, is this really like a good variable name? Is it really representing this value that we have inside of our list? So basically it's a string, it's a text. So why not call it string text? First of all, let's look at the variable name. It consists of two words, string and text. And now you should ask yourself, is each of these words really critical to the meaning of the value what we are holding here? What is the difference between a string and a text? Is it not basically the same? So why should we keep both string and text inside of the variable name if it is redundant, and therefore make sure that you first of all remove one of these names so that it is more precise, our name. And now you might think, okay, basically this is really great for our name because this value is basically a string or a text, whatever I put here inside, this is a great variable name. No, it is not a really great name for the variable because you should be also consistent with the naming of your variables throughout your whole code. Before, we have already given the name words and now we call it string, and this is a bit strange because this is basically the plural form, and inside of this anonymous function you put then the singular form of this name inside. And now this variable name is consistent with the other variable names within our code. So here we take then all the words, we search for the first word, and if this word contains the term Flutter, then we simply put it inside of this variable, inside of this result. The result name is also really long, therefore let's make it shorter. So let's think about what is this basically returning back. This is returning back this name Flutter, so we can call it name or we could call it result, which is really short. I call it in this case name. And lastly, the method name could be also shorter. Therefore, let's think about what is this basically returning. Okay, it is returning a name. Therefore, you shouldn't call it, for example, extract text, since this would not be consistent with what we are basically returning here. So it would make more sense to simply call it extract name so that it is also consistent with what we return.